And we just left Sydney, headed to Russell Island. Russell Island is the home of an ancient clam garden. We try to get to these clam gardens every 2 weeks. Looking forward to getting out there today.
The seaweed is quite heavy in this area.
There's a lot right now. Yeah. This is like more than...
This clam garden is over 600 years old and fed families and peoples here for thousands of years. And we get to be working on it today. So we'll be tilling the beach and removing some of this seaweed that we see here behind us and looking at the wall and seeing if the wall needs any more work, guided by our ȾEMÁȻES Indigenous partners here. Behind me here, we have the control side of the beach where we were not doing any work on the beach. And then behind me here is the active side of the beach where we are actively restoring the beach. We're trying to tell the difference between what happens when we take care of a beach actively and when we leave one to itself and sees what the difference is. Every year we come here, we take care of the beach, and then we monitor the population to see how the clams are doing and see how they're responding to our efforts.
Part of ancestral management practices at the HHs is to remove seaweed because it can kind of suffocate the clams underneath it. But we also noticed that in the seaweed, a lot of clam spat lays itself and attaches, and the little juvenile clams start to grow in the seaweed. And so if we're pulling away all the seaweed, sometimes we're pulling away baby clams. So today, as we're raking up the seaweed, we're just looking through to see if there are any juvenile clams in it and pulling them out.
The more connected you are to it, the more you care for it. We know that when you maintain it, just like a garden from home, it prospers. So it's important to really look after what you have. And when you do that, it looks after you.
Hi, I'm Phil Tom from the Tsartlip First Nation. My wilderness name is Chilton from the Tom and Bartleman family in Tsartlip. I'm part of the WLC and Parks Canada program to do the clam garden restoration project. I'm very happy to be a part of it and learning lots.
Another part of our job is every week we come out here and we gather mussel samples from these bags, grab one of these samples, we take it off the line, we take it back to our office, and we ship it over to Burnaby, to the lab there. And the reason we do this is to test whether the mussels have biotoxins in them. Biotoxins are from a natural producing algae. They can be harmful for humans when consumed in large amounts. So we test these to make sure that when people are eating clams here, that they're safe. In the summertime here, clams are closed, but in the wintertime, there's more safe openings and opportunities to harvest.